Oh, fine. It's a bit puerile even for you, Connors.
Actually, I was thinking of inviting you to an official competition, seeing as how we beat you at the volleyball. Everything under control, Miss Ferguson?
Yes, Governor. These two are just about to clean up their mess.
How did it happen?
Well, we thought there was this fire. We didn't want to disturb everyone watching.
Another word, Connors, and you'll find yourself in solitary.
Seems this sort of thing runs in your family. All good, clean fun until someone gets hurt.
If you're talking about bunk...
I'm talking about you. You've been in far too much trouble lately. Unless I see an improvement, you'll earn yourself a visit from the VJ. Is that understood?
Whatever you say.
Exactly. Mrs. Morris?
Get on with it.
Lucky Maxwell got away. Otherwise, we'd really been in it.
It would have been worth it.
Yeah.
Stop the chatter.
Tomorrow.
Yeah? Well, I can't hang around here any longer. You said yourself the cops are tailing you.
Yeah, but I won't be seeing you for months. Look, can't you hang it off for a couple of days?
No! Gonna need some money, too. Queensland's a long ride. Petrol's gonna cost heaps.
Look, I told you, I'm not pinching nothing from Eddie.
Well, I don't care where we get it, just get it!
Well, none of my friends have got any.
What about I?
Ida? You gotta be kidding. She can't hardly rub 2 cents together.
Don't you believe her? She's still got a heap from that stuff we shifted into REIT. Couldn't have spent it yet, nothing to spend it on.
All right. I'll ask her.
You do that. And, I'll tell her I'll give it back to her when I get a job.
What are you going to do up there?
I don't know. Cane cutting, peanut farmer, something will come up.
They won't stop looking for you, you know.
Yeah, I know. I'll head over to Western Australia. But I reckon they can't trace you in those big mines over there.
Look, you can always give yourself up.
Are you crazy or something?
Well, at least you'd still be around. The cops will go easy on
you. The cops don't go easy on bikies!
Not if you give yourself
up! Look, just shut up, will you? Go and see Ide. Well, go on!
See you, lover.
Don't mean the end of us. It's just until things cool off, okay?
Hey, Maxwell, move it, will you? You haven't said boo since we've been here.
I've been thinking about Connors, what you said about combining forces.
Yeah?
You're right. There's no point trying to take her on alone. She's got too much support. But if we can pull that support out from under her...
Now you're talking.
With the women on our side, Connors will never treat us like dirt again.
You can't expect Jess to buy a camera for us.
Why not? She'd be in it like a rocket.
Well, you heard what Mervyn said. They're very expensive.
Yeah, maybe we should just all save up for
on $1.60 a day.
Well, we'll have to think of something. It'd be a good way of coping with the boredom.
Yeah, well, our bag's been director.
Oh, what would you know about directing?
Oh, it's easy. All you do is say, lights, camera, action. Hey, we could do one of them serials, you know? All dress up as rich bitches, having to get the old man's empire.
We're a bit daggy looking for rich people. Yeah.
I was thinking more of a chat type show, like they have on the lunchtime.
Yeah. Oh, they're boring.
No, they're not. One of us could be the host and we could interview the others.
Discuss current issues.
Yeah, like there's a rumour going around that the freak's really King Kong after he's had a shave. Would you care to comment, Miss Egbert?
No, I was thinking of serious interviews. And then afterwards we could do a documentary on life inside.
Oh, look, he's angling to be director now.
Well, maybe we should just wait till we get a camera.
How'd it go?
Yeah, what the freak want?
Oh, she wanted us to clean up the mess we made after giving Maxwell a body shampoo.
Yeah, with a fire extinguisher.
You're joking!
For wrecking the tape, but I
thought... For everything. For lagging, for pulling the dorm apart, for not waking up to herself.
Oh, yeah, should have seen her.
The screws know what happened.
All they know is Lurch and me emptied a fire extinguisher.
But the further we persecute her, the more we alienate.
Oh, sing another song, will you, Nance? Now, come on, tell us all about the royal wedding.
Yeah,
oh, hey, what happened after you saw the minister?
Oh, no. You saw a dress.
Yeah.
I can't wait that long. It has to be now, before she thinks of some other way of getting at me.
Calm down. We stick together, we'll be okay.
If they see us together, they'll have more reason than ever to play tough.
Not while I got this, they won't. My insurance policy protects two just as easy as one.
Do they know you've got that?
Will do, the minute they try something. Here, Get a feel of it.
No, thanks.
Suit yourself. Got it from Miss Sheila in C Block. Wasn't cheap. If you want support, you've got to pay for it. Fact of life.
You want money? Is that it?
Can't do much without it. You must have a bit tucked away for a rainy day.
Assuming I have, how do you intend to use it?
Buy more of these, of course. And a bit of muscle. Enough to show the others that we're serious about doing Connors.
And how do I know you won't take the money and just leave me high and dry?
Because I want Connors off my back just as much as you do. Geez, I don't enjoy carrying a knife around with me just so as I'll know I'll make it to my next breakfast. But it's better than having Connors use you as a bloody doormat 24 hours a day.
Are you sure the money will do it?
Haven't seen anyone knock it back yet.
I'll ring my husband tonight. We'll have it by tomorrow morning.
Keep your eye on the road there, dearie.
Yeah, well, it's all right for you. You didn't spend half the night hassling money for Bongo.
The cheek of that bloody fella thinking I could lend him some, you know. I spent mine on getting my vehicle back on the road. Nice little job, isn't it, eh? That's as reliable as the day she was made. Now, when you're going to stick up a milk bar here, you've got to do it nice and early because them people are bleary-eyed, you see. They'll never know what hit them. Hey, looks bloody real, don't it?
Bloody hell, I'd put it away. Someone will see it.
Don't forget to take it when you go where.
This is bloody stupid. Don't you know anyone else who could lend us the dough?
The only one who would have. Danny boy.
Maybe you could ask Bongo to, you know, stop. We could go back there on the way.
No way, not my problem, dear. Mind you, I'll tip the young bugger up for what he done. But you can't question your fellow when he makes up his mind to do something. Now, would you like me to drive so you'll get there all relaxed, eh?
No, look, I'm right. What's going on? I thought you said this car was reliable.
Don't worry, Sophie. Only gets a bit excited.
Oh, God.
I couldn't shut her up. She kept coming up with ideas for this video club of hers in the middle of the bloody night.
Well, if we do want Jackie to help, we can have some ideas to put forward.
Hey, I've got one.
Hey, everyone, Lois has got an idea.
You know, the bloke that showed us how to use the weight. Well, we could film him, you know, working out, getting all sweaty and everything.
Oh, I can't tell it. Come on, Jules, baby. I know it's been on the cold water.
Hey, see you, Michael.
What's all this racket?
Oh, nothing, good, Mum. Get a move on, will you? And stop fooling around. Look, you buggers.
Hey, Ned, I've got an idea for a film. Attack of the Green Slime with Williams playing the slime.
I hope you've been with her as an accident, Lexi. We've got a right to hang around with whoever we like. Or has that changed too?
You're getting a bit ahead of yourself, Worm.
Yeah, we still owe you.
A bit late, aren't you? Middle one's free, Pat.
Just rack off! Jules was here before you!
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Bullet doesn't! Are we gonna drag her out or what?
That was a bad move, sister.
Bloody hell!
I regretted striking